Hi, my name is Lawrence Freedom and I'm with Freedom Center. And tonight we're going to talk about the cycle of dependency. Alcohol and drug dependency is a very complex and very baffling disease that affects millions of people, men and women alike. And one of the challenges that most people have is how someone can get caught in this cycle to where they're willing to sacrifice the people they love, as well as everything that they value because of this addictive process. Tonight I'm going to show you what this addictive process is so that you, whether you are dealing with this disease directly or if you are a family member, can have a better understanding of this natural cycle and, more important, what you can do to break out of it. So the cycle of dependency first starts with the feelings. And what we understand when we start talking about people who are caught up with a drinking problem or a drug addiction problem is that they have created this association between their feelings, whether they're feeling happy or they're feeling sad, this connection of reaching for a drink or alcohol or some drugs in order to change or to mood alter that feeling experience. Now, the fact that a person with an addiction problem reaches for that substance, puts it inside their bodies, is not really the problem when we're talking about an addiction. The problem lies with the third part, and that third part is that the brain, the part that is the functioning part for our decision making as well as our behavior, that it is different in the brain of the addict or the alcoholic. And the way it's different is that when that mood altering substance, whether it be alcohol or whether it be drugs, is added to the addict or the alcoholic, what happens is that the addict or alcoholic find themselves no longer in their right state of mind. Or what we would say is that they lose control. That the substance actually has a way of hijacking that higher functioning thinking to where the addict or the alcoholic now behaves in ways that causes all sorts of consequences. They end up doing things that when they're in the right mind they don't do. Or they end up saying things that when they're in the right minds they don't say. But nonetheless, when they are taken over by the substance because of how it interacts and affects the thinking or the brain directly, they end up making decisions that cause all sorts of consequences personally, where sometimes they get injured or auto accidents, maybe affecting their freedom to where they get themselves caught in a legal situation, and most definitely where it ends up hurting the people that they love. Now, the problem for the addict or the alcoholic is that they don't understand this until they start understanding this cycle of dependency. But what happens when that mood-altering substance wears off and that the ability to now start seeing what looks like the landscape of their lives, when that dust settles and they start sobering up, is that they start recognizing or realizing the consequence of what has occurred this time because they lost control. And as they are having to face or confront the new situation or the pain that they've created, the natural consequence is that they start experiencing a tremendous amount of guilt that then starts shifting into shame, where they end up feeling all this guilt and regret, but it becomes even more emphasized, it becomes more exaggerated into shame. And when it becomes this place of shame, then they find themselves wanting to distance themselves from this experience. They want to distance themselves from the people that make them bring into this experience, and they want to run away. And so the natural thing when they're in this place of shame is that they want to run away. And the irony is that what they do is they try to respond to this problem, this disease of addiction that is primarily defined by being out of control, by going now into a mode of what I call super control. And this mode of super control is a way of wanting to distance from feeling so bad, all that regret, all that remorse, as well as the shame thinking, that critical thinking, and the feelings that come with that shame. And when they go into their super control, it's not unusual that the addict or the alcoholic will start making all sorts of promises, promises on how they're going to change, promises. They might even make promises on how they're going to stop drinking or using drugs. The problem, though, is that they're still in this cycle of dependency, because this is just another portion of this cycle. And in this cycle of dependency, what we find is that the denial is primarily run by three rules. The first rule is that you just don't trust. The second rule is that you don't really talk about what's going on. You avoid talking about it. You get angry when people want to talk about it. And then lastly, the third rule of denial is where you don't feel. You cut off and you try to push down or to repress whatever feelings there are, because when you allow yourself to feel, it actually engages that shame again. And so in this super control, the person is trying to control their outer environment, they're trying to control their feelings, they're trying to control all the people that are in their lives so that they don't have to deal with the reality that they have this problem, as well as the shame. However, super control is not the solution. What happens with the super control is that there's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of time where the feelings that is the primary catalyst of this cycle end up becoming so exaggerated, so intense, that for the addict or the alcoholic, they can convince themselves that this, they can take a drink or they can pop a pill and be able this time to do it without any consequence, as a way of once again changing how they're feeling. The sad thing about it is this is a biological problem related to the brain. And that the reality is that if when an addict or an alcoholic has this problem, they cannot take that pill without eventually falling back into this part of the cycle, losing control, having more consequences in their life, more pain in their life, more pain in the lives of the people around them, and then back with more shame piled on top of shame, and then super control. And in my years of working with people who have addiction problems, this cycle is a cycle that every addict that I've ever spoken to identifies with. The only thing that they talk that is a little different is how fast it takes them to make a full rotation with a cycle. The other thing that changes is the level of consequence when they're in this loss of control. The solution is to get some help. And at Freedom Center, we have been working with addicts and alcoholics for years. We have trained professionals that can help you. And if you have a loved one that's dealing with, we can help your loved one start understanding how to break out of this cycle and to be able to become free so they can get themselves back, restoring complete health, body, mind, spirit. Today is a day where if you need the help, call us. I'm Lawrence Freedom. I'm with Freedom Center, 303-420-9430.